First of all, I would like to thank you very much. The organizing committee and especially Helen Moment that you invite me to join the AMF cholangiocarcinoma meeting today. Today I would like to talk about cholangiocarcinoma in Thailand and in Southeast Asia. As we know that cholangiocarcinoma the risk factor from the liver group, and the second unknown or from the hepatitis B or hepatitis C. In Thailand and Southeast Asia, such as Laos, PDR, Cambodia, Myanmar, and Vietnam, cholangiocarcinoma risk factor is from the liver fluke. In the year 2014, we celebrate our 58th anniversary year. It's the year of social devotion. We start the cholangiocarcinoma screening and care program. We want to the objective, our objective, we want to eliminate liver fluke. And the second is to screen and care for the risk group. And the third, to screen and care for the disease group. And we want to make it the national health policy to combat the cholangiocarcinoma. And the last objective, we want to have a clinical practice guideline for screening, diagnosis, and treatment. The theme of project is Fluke-Free Thailand. We have 11 projects, such as food safety and fluke-free features. And we want to eliminate liver fluke from OV in cats and dogs. And we have our 6 million population that infected by the liver fluke. We want to screen and diagnosis and treatment of the 6 million population. And also we want to handle with the sanitary problem. And we want to teach the our school children how to know about the danger of the raw attitude and also food safety. And then we want to screen and the CCA risk group and diagnosis and treatment. And we want to do the clinical trial for adjuvant and palliative therapy. And also we want to have the policy research for making new policy to combat the liver fluke and cholangiocarcinoma. And we want to study the social science and humanities and also geographic information system project. This is our 11 project. And today I would like to talk about the result of ultrasound screening in the cholangiocarcinoma risk group. We start the ultrasound screening since 2014 and from the northeast of Thailand and then go to the north provinces and one province in the east of Thailand. The screening we campaign in the large group and also our network of ultrasound. In the 2019, we already screened the ultrasound 751,000 people already, and we have positive ultrasound for cholangiocarcinoma 1,248 people. The results of the ultrasound screening, the preliminary result, we will talk about the figure of the cholangiocarcinoma, like the location and morphology, and also the state of cholangiocarcinoma and survival rate of cholangiocarcinoma. Since the beginning in February 2014 up to June 2019, 766 cholangiocarcinoma patients with histological proven and have information of tumor location and morphology. In 766 cholangiocarcinoma patients, we can divide in to the screening group 163 and in the walk-in symptomatic group 603 patients. The percentage of intrahepatic cholangiocarcinoma is 50.1%. The perihilar cholangiocarcinoma is 39.0%, and distal cholangiocarcinoma is 10.9%. And tumor morphology is mass forming 43.9%, and periductal infiltration 31.4%, and intraductal cholangiocarcinoma is 18%. Is mixed, it's about 6.7%. Tumor location, intrahepatic cholangiocarcinoma, mass forming about 64%. Perihilar cholangiocarcinoma is a periductal infiltration 52%. And distal cholangiocarcinoma, the most morphology is the periductal infiltration is 42.0%. In the screening patient, intrahepatic cholangiocarcinoma is 66.5, but in the walk-in symptomatic patient, it's 45.5%. But the perihilar is in the screening, it's 21.1, and the walk-in symptomatic is 42.3%. The distal cholangiocarcinoma in screening patient is 6.8%. And walk-in patient is 11.8%. The state of cholangiocarcinoma in the screening patient is very interesting that we have the state 0 to state 2 is 84.6%. But in the non-participant walk-in symptomatic patient, we have the advanced state 78.28%. So we can see that in our study, we in hospital cholangiocarcinoma or in symptomatic cholangiocarcinoma, we have only 10 to 20% patient that present early stage disease and candidate for curative resection. But in our screening patient, we have 84. And for the CCA screening, we can improve percent of detection for the early stage cholangiocarcinoma patient, and it's increased the number of candidate patient for curative resection. The survival of the cholangiocarcinoma, overall, survival, 5-year survival in overall patient is 73.9%, and median time survival is 18.5. In screening patient, the 5-year survival is 48.3% and 58.7 months median time survival. In walk-in patient, we have 5-year survival 17.3 and median time survival is 14.2 months. In early stage, 5-year survival is 48.2 and median time survival is 58.7. In late stage, we have 5-year survival 10% and median survival time is 11.4. So the example of the 5-year survival rate of some CCA type that the survival more than 50% is the in early stage intrahepatic cholangiocarcinoma, 5-year survival rate is 53%, and early stage intraductal cholangiocarcinoma is 51.6%, and early stage periductal infiltration is 50.8%, and in screening intraductal cholangiocarcinoma is 64.0%. So our conclusion of our screening 5-year, we can say that in CAT-CAP screening activities incur new simple tools and surveillance system for cholangiocarcinoma detection, and we can improve early stage CCA cases and cholangiocarcinoma survival rate, and provide potential reliable evidence for decision making in treating cholangiocarcinoma patients. So in our Southeast Asian or neighboring countries such as Laos, PDR, Myanmar or Cambodia or southern part of Vietnam, we want to help and initiate the prevention and screening and treatment program that we start in Laos PDR in 2019. We start from April 2019 in Pak Ngum City, Vientiane Chan, Laos PDR, and we collect a specimen for screening liver fluke, and also kick off a workshop liver fluke and cholangiocarcinoma screening at Vientiane in April 2019, and ultrasound screening at the Pak Ngum City, Vientiane, Laos PDR in the April. And then we do the operation for us ultrasound screening positive cholangiocarcinoma patient at Mahosot Hospital, Vientiane, Laos PDR in August 2019. And we would like to say that in Thailand and also in the neighboring country, we do the primary care project and secondary care project and even tertiary care and training doctor for the combat cholangiocarcinoma project in 11 project in the team of Flukri Thailand. We already start in Thailand and also for 5 years and also 1 year in Laos PDR. We would like to campaign this in the Cambodia and also Myanmar and Vietnam if possible. But we have to stop the screening program because of the pandemic of the SARS-CoV-19. But we hope that in the next future, we will go to our neighboring country. And also in Thailand, we will go for the elimination of the liver fluke. And in 5 years, we think that we can have more and more early detection of cholangiocarcinoma and cure the people. And I hope that in the future, from our project and combat the liver fluke and cholangiocarcinoma like this, we help the people from this disease. I thank you very much for your attention.